Hey guys, here we are, week four. This has just been an amazing week. I have to say that in the previous weeks, like the first week, I was lethargic and not feeling great. Second week, I was getting the keto flu. Third week, I was beginning to improve, but now I am absolutely on top of the world. My depression's gone. I am feeling amazing now. I'm finding I've got a lot more energy. I'm sleeping better. I'm sleeping longer. It's just been an amazing ride this week. And I've been, you know, I've included liver back into my diet, and I'm feeling on top of the world. Also, as of today, I am cutting out milk from my diet. So milk is not going to be a part of my diet anymore. I used to have a bit of milk in my coffees, and basically now I am cutting milk out of my diet, out of my coffees altogether, and I'm just using cream instead. I know some people are really dogmatic about not even having coffee, but that's great. You know, I'm not there yet. One day, maybe I will, but right now, I'm just not quite there. So it's a process. You know, I gave up sugar. I gave up all the stuff, a lot of other stuff I love. Now, I'm not saying this in a way that's going to be negative towards the carnivore diet, because that's not what I'm doing. I'm just saying that I've let go of a lot of that rubbish. I'll call it rubbish instead. I let go of all that other rubbish because I want to live a life where I'm going to be healthier and lose the weight that I want to get down to. Now, the energy levels I have skyrocketed. I haven't felt this good. I used to go on ashwagandha tablets to help me with my depression. Now, I have to say that my depression has completely left me. And the best part about that is that I feel like I've been taking ashwagandha even though I haven't. The carnivore diet has helped me that much. I don't know if you've ever had ashwagandha or not, but I have. And I took it for months. And then since going on the carnivore diet, you know, I stopped taking them for a while. Going on the carnivore diet, I haven't touched ashwagandha at all. Now I feel amazing. I feel like I had been taking ashwagandha. My temper has substantially decreased. I'm a lot calmer around people. I don't find myself getting aggravated or irritated as easily. And people are saying, my family included, are saying I'm much better to be around, which is fantastic. I still have Graves' disease, which is obviously my thyroid glands, which is a hypothyroidism. But I believe that this carnivore diet will eventually help that, and also will eventually get to the point where I can reduce my blood pressure as well. I do believe that I'll be able to go off all my medications in the end. Now, saying that, what's going to be coming up? Well, I'm going to start doing things like creating meals. Now, just be aware, I'm not a professional chef. And the meals I create won't always necessarily look fantastic. And I'm not going to be presenting them in such a way that they are going to look pretty. But what I will be doing is showing you every step of the process of whatever it is I'm doing. And this way, we can all join in and do this ourselves. Carnivore diet doesn't have to be boring. It doesn't have to be, you know, beef, lamb, chicken, pork, or fish 100% of the time. Well, it does have to be some of that, one of those. But what you need to do is you can mix it up by having things like cheese sauces. You can also have things like your bone broth as a base for a stew, or you can have a whole bunch of different other things. It doesn't have to be all the same thing all the time. I don't have to have steak one day, pork chops the next day, lamb chops the next day, chicken drumsticks or chicken the next day. And it doesn't have to be that. It can be, you can mix it up. You can do things like quiches, or you can do things like lasagnas, or you can do a whole bunch of different things, still keeping it within the carnivore realm. We've got so many carnivore options. For example, the other day I created, I watched a video from Chris Cooking Nashville. If you ever get a chance, check out his channel. He's great. Chris Cooking Nashville, he showed how to create, of all things, mac and cheese. I love mac and cheese. But he did it with chicken. And instead, and he blended up the chicken so that it became like a paste. And then he piped it out into boiling water until it became about the size of pasta. And then you made up the cheese sauce, which was completely carnivore, and put that over the top of the pasta that he'd cooked in the water. And then it was just delicious. I mean, there are lots of different options that you can do. It doesn't have to be boring. And that's just something I want to be trying to instill into my community, is we don't have to have boring foods all the time. Because otherwise, you'll get what's called palate exhaustion, and basically you'll just get bored with the same things all the time. So to avoid that, we need to get a bit of variety. All right, guys, that's all there is for this particular video. Now, I am going to try and upload new videos every single day. I was doing it once a week, but I feel as though I should probably do it daily as a way to journal this journey that I'm actually on. And hopefully, you'll be able to come along for the ride and enjoy what we're going through and what we're doing. All right, guys, if you got some value out of this video, have you smash the like button, as well as subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you can be notified when we upload more videos. Hey, while you're at it, why not consider sharing? Also, leave a comment down below and let me know how you're going on your carnivore diet, or if you've even started. Also, to let you know, the right here is a video I believe you might like. Down here is a video YouTube thinks you might like. And right here is an image of my head. Now, if you click on that, you'll be able to subscribe. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and bye for now.